So today's coffee break is on the year-end closing process. It's a pretty simple process, but people don't do it very often, usually once a year, and therefore you tend to forget the steps. So I just want to go over it with you and sort of some best practices. First of all, backup. Make sure that you've got a good backup. Confirm that you've got a backup before you get started. That's first things first. Also, you should know that the year-end process can be done at any point during the year. So if it's July and you're embarrassed because you haven't done it yet, it's fine. You're probably one of many, many people. Most people, it takes a while because you need to get your numbers from your accountant, get all your final numbers in, and then you're ready to do the process. So if you need help from us, don't be embarrassed. It is not uncommon to be doing it very, very late. So, and NAV doesn't care, so don't worry about it. All right, so in this database, we're going to go ahead and do a 2016 close. I've technically confirmed that my backup's good. The other thing that you should know is that if you normally run the inventory, the adjust cost process for your month end, then you'll want to run that before you do your year end. If you do not normally perform this task, do not do it. It will cause you lots of pain. So you're really only going to do it if this is something that you typically do in your system. So let's go ahead and do that first. All right. Let's go to departments, financial management, inventory. And down here we have our adjust cost. So we're just going to run that right quick. I'm going to go ahead and post the GL, click OK. Oh, that was quick. And everything's been run from my adjust cost. Again, don't do that if you don't normally do that. Now, the next thing that I would recommend you do is that you go ahead and print any of your reports that you normally would print for month end or year end and go ahead and save them. So you can print them to PDF and save them. The data won't really, it shouldn't change after this process, but people like to have that snapshot. So go ahead and run your AP customer account detail reports, your vendor account detail. If you run your inventory to GL reconciliation report, that big guy, you're going to want to run that. So just make sure you've got everything in place. So we're going to pretend I've already done that. The next thing I want to mention that if you're using foreign currency, you're going to go ahead and run that periodic activity. If you're running, if you're using jobs, you're going to want to go ahead and do those periodic activities so that you get your WIP and recognition. And if you're using payroll, if you're one of the few people who have NAV payroll, you'll want to do the year-end payroll. You want to make sure that all that information's been updated. All right. So now that that's done, we're going to go over here to our general ledger, periodic activities. And we're going to go to the fiscal year. So the first thing we want to do is close the accounting periods. So I click in accounting periods, and you'll see that 15 has already been closed. We're doing 16 right now. So I just need to go up here to close year. And it just confirms that that's indeed what I want to do, that these are the dates I'm closing. And I'm going to click yes. Now, just so you know, once you close a year, you can still post into the prior year. It just gets a little mark on the record that lets us know that it was posted into a closed year. So you can still make entries. It's not uncommon for you to do a year-end close, get more adjustments from your accountant, and have to back post them. That's totally fine. So you don't need to worry about that. You're not locked out forever. Now, what I like to do as a best practice is after I've done my year-end close, I go ahead and create the next year in the system. I've only got a few years created in here, so I'm going to go ahead and go to create year and just create my next year. We'll do 12 months and click OK. All right, so I've got my next years created. Let's go ahead and close that. Now we're ready to close the income statement. So it wants to know what the fiscal year end date is, which is the 31st. I'm on a calendar year. And then it wants to know which journal template I'm going to use. So I'm going to use my general journal. And then which journal batch. I'm just going to use my default batch. Sometimes people create a year-end batch for this process so they can kind of segregate it from your other batches. I'm going to click OK. And I need to just establish my retained earnings account. And then I have in here a description that comes up. Let me open this up a little. And I can augment that or change it. You can have it be whatever you'd like for it to be. All right, if you are using dimensions, you will want to check the dimensions that you use and make sure that they are included in your year end. Okay, now I just click OK. It creates the journal. And now I'm going to go to my general ledger. And I'm going to go to my general journal. And we're going to pull up that default journal batch. All right, and here are all my entries. So right now I see that I had some old work in here. So let me just delete that. You should probably check your batch before you go through this process so you're not doing what I'm having to do. Okay, and what I want you to notice here is that the posting date begins with a C. So we know that these are closing entries. There's another flag that's sort of hidden that also indicates that it's a closing entry. And the reason I tell you that is because the posting date having a C is a system-generated date. If I just type in C, that's not going to create a closing entry because that flag behind the scenes is not being set. So you really only see this date when you've run the periodic activity that created this journal. So I just want to point that out. Now, what it does is it shows me for each account, each of my expense accounts, income statement accounts, it shows me the adjustment being made to the account to wipe it out. And then down here, my last line, I see the total amount that's going to be posted to retained earnings. So once I confirm that everything looks good, I go ahead and click post. And it tells me that it was successfully posted. So I'm going to go ahead and close out of here. And now I'm going to show you what it did. So if I go to the chart of accounts, here's my retained earnings account, and I click into this net change, I can see it created a closing entry into the retained earnings account. All right. I could also, if I go to navigate, I can see all the entries that were affected by that close. So I can click on show related entries, and now you see everything that was posted. That concludes our coffee break on processing your year-end close.
Thanks for watching this Archerpoint video. If you found it helpful, make sure to check out our website and blog at www.archerpoint.com. Additionally, if you have any questions regarding our products, services, or information in this video, feel free to email us at info@archerpoint.com. Thanks.